That's a day I'm never getting back. Oh, hey, look at that. Too late for marsh duty.
Yeah, it's too bad, huh?
Schizo. Speaking of schizo, I wonder what the hell he did all day.
Hey, Ricky, you there? I'm gonna be gone for a while. I need you to cover for me. Skiz is gonna wonder why I'm not out on marsh duty or whatever the hell.
Hey, Deke. What's up?
Boozer's, hell. I don't know. He's depressed or something. Talk to Addy. I think I know a way to cheer him up.
So, what are you gonna do?
Well, I thought I'd maybe head to O'Leary Mountain, get his bike, bring him back.
That's a long way to go on foot.
Let's figure something out. Are you gonna cover for me or what?
Yeah.
Thanks, Ricky. Geeking out.
O'Brien, I'm at one of your beacons, the one near Camp Creek. There's nothing here.
Hold on. Okay. A field op should be there any minute. You know the drill. O'Brien out.
Yeah, I know the drill. Try not to get my ass shot off while being your goddamn peeping Tom. St. John out. Yeah, so what was that all about? I mean, last time we talked, it sounded like you were pissing your hazmat suit.
It's nothing. I told you there are people above me who don't want us to know what's going on. I got too close. I almost got caught.
You know what? I don't give a shit. All I want from you is information on Sarah.
Whitaker, I've got someone working on it. It's gonna take time. I guess you have to be patient.
Yeah? I got a lot of choice here, do I?
This research group isn't part of my unit, so I can't track them after this op. I need you to...
Place a tracker on their chopper. Yeah, I get it. Oh, and you want me to spy on the guy wearing the white spacesuit. Yeah, anything else?
Yeah, try not to get your ass shot off. Your, comm was still open before. Don't think of it as, like, being meeting Tom. It's more like opposition research.
Additionally, the subject is wearing jewelry and clothing less tattered and worn than Hey, sorry. Couldn't help overhearing.
Gun-toting biology major.
Yeah, something like that. So, it's wearing jewelry. What's the significance of that?
These things have been out here for 2 years, scratching and clawing at us and each other.
Yeah.
Try putting a gold watch on a baboon for 2 years. Set it loose in the wild and see what happens to it.
Okay, I get your point.
This watch looks new.
Really? So?
So, that means this subject has either been taking care of it, or has recently...
Recently put it on. Shit, I thought they were all, you know...
Bad shit crazy? Yeah, they are, but... Just as some late-stage dementia patients could still have moments of lucidity, victims of stage 2 virus infections seem to retain some level of vestigial memory.
Oh shit.
No shit. Look at its clothes.
Field
note 2068. Another subject exhibiting the morphology of stage 2 infection. Tendons in the hands and fingers are less constricted, fingernails less claw-like, as if recently chewed. Additionally, the subject is wearing jewelry and clothing less tattered and worn than...
Hey, sorry. Couldn't help overhearing.
Gun-toting biology major.
Yeah, something like that. So, it's wearing jewelry. What's the significance of that?
These things have been out here for 2 years, scratching and clawing at us and each other.
Yeah.
Try putting a gold watch on a baboon for 2 years. Set it loose in the wild and see what happens to it.
Okay, I get your point.
This watch looks new.
Really? So?
So, that means this subject has either been taking care of it, or has recently...
Recently put it on? Shit, I thought they were all, you know...
Bad shit crazy? Yeah, they are, but... Just as some late-stage dementia patients could still have moments of lucidity, victims of stage 2 virus infections seem to retain some level of vestigial memory.
Oh, shit.
No shit. Look at its clothes.
They're
almost clean, right? I mean, not clean, but most freaks are so caked with shit and piss.
That's disgusting.
Yeah, well, again, put a pair of pants on a baboon for 2 years.
Jeez.
Subject exhibiting the morphology of stage 2 infection. Tendons in the hands and fingers are less constricted, fingernails less claw-like, as if recently chewed. Additionally, the subject is wearing jewelry and clothing less tattered and worn than...
Hey, sorry. Couldn't help overhearing.
Gun-toting biology major.
Yeah, something like that. So, it's wearing jewelry. What's the significance of that?
These things have been out here for 2 years, scratching and clawing at us and each other.
Yeah.
Try putting a gold watch on a baboon for 2 years. Set it loose in the wild and see what happens to it.
Okay, I get your point.
This watch looks new.
Really? So?
So, that means this subject has either been taking care of it, or has recently...
Recently put it on? Shit, I thought they were all, you know...
Bad shit crazy? Yeah, they are, but just as some late-stage dementia patients could still have moments of lucidity, victims of stage 2 virus infections seem to retain some level of vestigial memory.
Oh, shit.
No shit. Look at its clothes.
They're
almost clean, right? I mean, not clean, but most freaks are so caked with shit and piss.
Yeah, it's disgusting.
Yeah, well, again, put a pair of pants on a baboon for 2 years.
My men are authorized to shoot on sight.
Well, what it means is that some freaks get up in the morning, they shower, they get dressed, they put on their favorite gold watch, they kiss their wife goodbye, and then they head out the door for a fun day of eating us and shitting themselves. Why the hell are these guys wasting their time with...
Stop, or we'll shoot!
Just gotta get the hell out of here. O'Brien,
how
you there?
Long does it take?
O'Brien!
Won't be too long. Doctor,
hold on. Yeah, I'm here.
I planted your tracking device and I got your data.
The researcher, were they male or female?
What? Why?
Was it a man or a woman?
It was a woman, and no, I didn't catch her name.
Okay. I'll be in touch. O'Brien out.
I got a use for you.
Hey, Ricky, did you send some men to go out and get him?
Yeah, he's a lot more cooperative all of a sudden. Evidently, our guys got to him just before a swarm. They offered to leave him where he was if he didn't tell him where the seeds were.
Oh, so weird. Yeah, I really would have just left him there to rot.
Yeah, you know what Iron Mike would say about that?
Yeah, I know. See you, Ricky.
Down Eric Lynch.
Oh yeah, Mike. I found him.
I want to thank you for not killing the man. We're gonna have a trial. He'll get a chance to tell his side of it.
Yeah, that's great. Yeah, too bad Campbell and Reed aren't allowed to tell their side.
Hey, we got folks that'll be there, speaking on their behalf. And we got witnesses. It's the way we do things, Deke.
Why don't you give them to me for 5 minutes? You'll have a confession.
Thanks. We got it covered. Iron Mike out.
Deke, you there? I got out of the infirmary today, man. Addie said she'd heard enough of my whining to last her a lifetime.
Sounds like Addie. How's the arm?
You know, it's about 50% there. Sorry, a little amputee humor there. But seriously, though, it's like I can still feel my right hand, you know?
I think they call that phantom pain.
Yeah, that's what Addie said. It fucking sucks. I feel pain in my finger joints, you know? Like, after a long ride, your hand gets gummed up, you go to flex it, and... Anyway, I gotta get going. Skizzle's got me on farm duty. Gotta see if I can pay off these damn pain meds that Addie has me on. Later.
Later. There?
Yeah, Deke.
How you doing, brother?
Same as always. You still out there chasing choppers?
Yeah.
Figure out what the hell they're up to yet?
Not a clue. What O'Brien told me seems legit. Nero's out here, or they're running field missions, studying the freaks. No idea why.
Hey, I gotta get going. Schizo stopped by and said I'd be shoveling shit all day.
Tell Schizo to eat shit.
Yeah. Pass that along. Later.
Finally. Jesus.
There we go. Yeah, worth some credits. Ammo left. This'll do.
Here for your bike?
Having a look. Is that okay?
Probably draining a lot of gas riding the broken road. Need fuel?
This thing is completely broken. Beats me.
Yeah, your bike's looking good now.
Late.
Sure. All right. Later, Deke.
What?
Get out of the way.
Howdy.
Hello.
Been busy, huh?
That's all I got today.
Ah, okay. Bye.
Hey.
Hey, Blair.
Looking for something special? Yeah, good. Yep. Good choice. Okay. Here you go. All right. You would come back soon, huh?
Here for your bike?
I wonder about the freaker sometimes, you know? Like...
Let me get the gate.
Pain. Anything.
That's right, I gotta finish burning out these nests. I guess I'll come back here and finish burning this infestation zone later.
Bam!
Another bounty.
Hey, I brought you something.
Wait, what the fuck? You went up and got my bike?
Well, I didn't want Cope getting it, parting it out.
Jesus, Deke.
Hey, I mean, I mostly did it, you know, in case I need parts. It's not like your gimp ass is gonna need them.
Shit. Thanks, brother. That's the one thing I miss. Riding on the open road.
Addie just wanted me to tell you that she paid some men to go get your bike and bring it back. It's over at the mechanic shop.
Oh, wait, what?
You're welcome, Deke. Ricky out.
Deke, a group of men rode in, shot up the gate, and when we wouldn't let them in, they rode off.
Ah, shit. Which direction?
They headed west, but they didn't go far. They set up camp just north of Eden Hill. I think they might be planning another attack, so I need you to take a look.
Okay, right.
Yeah, I'll handle it.
Thanks, Deke.
Something?
Hey, how's life?
What can I get you? You go through a lot of this shit, yeah? Bike's looking pretty busted. Okay. See you around.
St. John, this is Mark Copeland at Deacon St. John.
Hey, Cope, what's up?
Just checking in. A couple of my men were up at the top of O'Leary Mountain the other day. Said they found a safe house set up in an old Forest Service watchtower.
Is that right?
Yes, sir, that's what I'm told. They said it was abandoned, but funny thing, whoever lived there left behind a bike. Good shape, too, by the sound of it.
Really?
Indeed.
Okay, Ricky, I'm near Eden Hill.
Can you handle it?
Okay, time to radio in and let Ricky know.
Deacon, how'd it go?
It's done. They won't be shooting up any more camps.
Whew, thank God. I'll let Iron Mike know. You know, keep this up and you and Mike are gonna be best friends before you know it. Bye, Deacon.
Those boys shot up the gate and took off.
Hey, Mike, yeah. I found them and they won't be coming back.
Seem like it's getting worse. The amount of squatters and drifters we got coming through. No offense to present company.
I'm taken. And yeah, Mike, it's getting worse. I don't know. Mike, I think it's like you were saying about tourists always coming up here from California. Well, I guess if I had the choice, yeah, I'd rather be here than down there.
So, see you, Deke. Iron Mike out.
I can fix this. Let's go.
Deacon, you there?
Yeah, Addie, what's up?
Can you stop by the infirmary when you get a chance?
Anything wrong?
No, I just need to talk to you.
Yeah, okay. Ricky, yeah. Okay, I'll be by. St. John out.
I doing when the world got sick?
Deke, I'm really worried.
Ricky, what's up?
The Butler twins, Abigail and Gabby. You know them?
No, but I've seen them around. What's going on? What's wrong?
They went out fishing yesterday, and they didn't come back.
Well, the lake shore is pretty safe so long as they stay out of the marsh.
That's just it. They weren't at Lost Lake. They went east, over to the Metolius River.
What the hell were they thinking? Okay, all right, yeah. I'll see if I can find them.
Deacon, thank you so much.
Hey, man.
Having a look. That okay?
You, need a refuel? All right, I got you. Sure, all right. Later, Deke.
What's going on? Hey, you. Okay, good.
That's it?
Yep. Thanks.
Hey, How's it going?
Hey, how's it going?
We offer a 30-day money-back guarantee, so as long as you never bring it back. Yep. That should work. Okay. Yep. Hey, see ya.
How's it going?
Hey, Ricky, what else can you tell me?
Before everything went to hell, the girl's family had a fishing site that they always used to go to. I marked it on your map.
Okay, I'll start there. Deacon out.
Okay, the girls were fishing. Oh, shit. Marauders, Jesus. This way. Jesus. Broke it over his head. Okay, way to go, Abigail. Don't go without a fight. Lead down this road.
Did it.
Abby, it's okay. Hey. I'm not here to hurt you. Ricky sent me.
They killed my sister. They killed Abigail.
No, I know. I'm sorry. We just have to get you back to camp. Come on, with me.
No. I can make it myself. I can.
Okay, go.
Thank you.
fuel can. Needed this.